oh, I'm just like casually rewiring my brain through subtle movement. That sounds bizarre.
I've had bad posture for my whole life. I feel like I'm pretty set in my ways. Is it really possible to like rewire my brain?
A long time ago, it was thought that you couldn't do that. Just think about the brain firing down like Christmas lights. If the path is gonna be going this way and you hit the on button, it just shoots down that way, you don't have a choice because that's the way the brain has learned how to fire. What we do is back it up and say, okay, if I move this way instead of that way, do I still have that same easy quality without that resistance? Once you change the direction or the amount of effort or the spatial orientation, the brain has to fire differently.
So is it like a massage?
The idea is to convey movement, a learning process, yeah. Not to knead out a knot or yeah. Not to make something move bigger.
When will I feel different? Will it be like immediately?
You will probably feel a major difference after one lesson.
I told Rich that I wanted to be a better runner, and he made me kind of aware of the different ways parts of my body moved and certain imbalances I had.
He's just kind of like pushing against my back ribs here. It kind of like rotates my body really slightly. And then on this side, it kind of just like doesn't move at all.
Once we started talking about my athletic history, I realized that the issues I have really aren't necessarily physical.
Kind of like a common theme is that like I never feel like I'm good enough.
You know, I know something, that's okay.
I'm sorry.
It really like struck me that just talking about it led me to that conclusion. And so he decided that the lesson would be about overcoming the toxic mindset that I have inside my head.
You're in charge, this is your lesson. If I move you and it creates any uncomfortability, anxiety, pain, you let me know and I'll do it different.
So I lay down on the table and he starts gently like adjusting my body.
Shift my rib cage in a little, did some weird stuff with my feet.
He's just sort of very gently sliding my head around. I'm curious for what you're feeling for.
When we start helping you feel this way, that way, forward, back, which way is easiest? So that by the time we're through, a lot of things have become easier, more or less pressure.
That you're applying?
Yeah.
I feel like I'm moving a lot more.
And that's not my question.
It would have to be.
No, don't think it, feel it. Remember we did this earlier? Feel where the pressure goes to now down your spine.
It feels like it goes like kind of straight down my spine, like not to like this. Left hip.
We like reassessed and now both sides of my body were moving a lot easier than they were before.
Okay, but like how did that happen?
Your brain and nervous system's job is to take that information which I'm creating through moving you and make sense out of it.
It was interesting because he wouldn't allow me to stand up on my own. He wanted to carry me to standing position, and that was apparently so that I didn't return to my old habits. He put his entire body weight on me, and I just stood there just fine because I was so well aligned. It's almost like being returned to your infancy.
If you watch a child, it doesn't just roll over from its back to its belly. It does many different iterations, many different approximations, until it finds that effortless way to do it. It's only when we attach value to it that we get in our own way.
So then in the second lesson, I decided, well, we got through all the mental stuff yesterday. Let's just talk about the marathon race that I'm doing. I talked about my hamstring injury and he said, walk backwards.
Be honest.
It doesn't hurt.
How about that idea?
Why? How?
It's about you sensing internally, experientially. Once you feel that and have a bodily sensation of that, you can do that over and over and over again because you have a reference point to it.
You know, bringing my hips forward or my shoulders back, my body does that in a certain way. My right shoulder is so much easier.
Isn't that crazy, right?
Which is weird because I feel like it's the opposite on my lower body.
And think about running. When you take a stride.
Oh, yeah. That makes sense. Rich kind of like adjusts me a little bit and shows me like an easier or more efficient way to do it.
Feel the difference when you go this way.
Yeah.
And then you have to use force then, right?
Right.
So, and when you do that way.
Yeah, that's much easier.
Much easier. So when you're running, if you find the trajectory where a force goes through you easier, means you don't have to work as hard to run.
Right.
Into the second day, I'm already thinking about things that sort of Rich showed me about like moving my knees forward and how that changes where even my head is positioned. It's like different points of my back are touching the table that like have never been touching a surface before.
When it comes to stand, he can articulate that in standing because we're standing right now. We're just in a different configuration in gravity.
I felt a lot lighter on my feet. I felt like I was just kind of like moving through space a lot easier. Feldenkrais probably works best when done over long periods of time with consistent practice. It only lasted like a couple hours and then I fell back into like old habits.
Thinking about making very small adjustments was something I'd never thought about before. I had never thought about standing up straighter from my chest before.
Definitely less of a skeptic because there was tangible proof at the end of each lesson, but I still don't fully understand it, and that still confuses me.
I really think that anyone could benefit from Feldenkrais with the right practitioner, but especially people who have been through a traumatic physical or mental experience. This could help open your body and mind up to the vulnerability that is required for healing.